Hey guys, what is up? Today I have a video for you reviewing the joystick from Budget Cassius. I really don't know what the name of this is. It's called Joystick, which is a really original name. I really don't know anything else about it. But it's for the iPad 1, iPad 2, and iPad 3. So it's basically a joystick that will allow you to take advantage of the virtual joystick in some of your games and use it with a real kind of suction cuppy joystick that you place on your iPad's bezel or part of the screen, and then you'll be able to use it with more tactile and haptic feedback, which will be much more convenient, I guess, if you want a better experience when you're playing those joystick enabled games. Now keep in mind that most of the games in your Apple App Store are not joystick games, so they will most likely not require you to use this product, and if you have this product always mounted on your screen, you're probably not going to find any use for it, and you're going to find it really annoying. Now, for example, if you wanted to use this product on your screen, let me just show you how annoying this could be. Because of this product's ability to kind of control the screen and act as a third finger, if you're going to use two fingers, this is kind of like a third finger, it kind of screws everything up if you're trying to use it, and it kind of screws up multi-touch. It doesn't really appear that much here, but if you're trying to do multiple different functions, it doesn't really work that well, and I personally did not like it. And you can't really see it right now, but when you're using it more frequently, you guys will definitely see that it does screw up some of the functions you guys most likely will use. I believe Safari was slightly screwed up when I was searching. This was up in the top right corner. I couldn't really see. I mean, it's just an obstacle to use this. So I personally did not like it that much in that sense. But otherwise, I'll tell you guys what else I don't really like and like about it. So the thing I don't like about it, which is probably the biggest thing for me, is that the suction cups on this thing literally suck. They suck more than anything else on the planet. Because this is, say, your normal suction cup that is actually good. See, what happens when I try to push this down onto the table, it's not coming back up. See, now I can't remove this if my life depended on it because of the fact that this doesn't not stick up at all, and I'm probably going to break my table before I lift this up. The only way to lift this up is because of this little tab right here, and because of that tab, I can lift this up. Now, if they were to somehow implement this technology, which is not hard to find, which is extremely common, and put it in those suction cups, I might find my experience slightly more enjoyable. But because they did not do that, it kind of sucks because they don't stay in place. And if you have a joystick that moves around while you're trying to use it, you can kind of imagine how it kind of sucks when you try to play gameplay. Now I'm going to stop using the word suck and I'm going to replace to another synonym of it. But I can't really say anything good about the suction cups because, I'm going to say it again, they suck. And because of that, the joystick moves around when you try to play a game. And as you can tell right here, I'm not trying to do this by moving it around, but it's moving it around. So it interferes with your normal use, and I find that to be really annoying. So let's just play a game of Iron Man right now. This is the demo version. And while it's loading, let me say that I did play Pac-Man with this, and Pac-Man was a less than enjoyable experience because if you do not align this joystick perfectly, you're going to have a major issue. This joystick requires itself to be applied perfectly. I mean pinpoint accuracy. If it's not pinpoint accurately placed on your screen, it's not going to align itself perfectly with the virtual joystick. If it's not aligned perfectly with the virtual joystick, it means it's not going to stick down properly, and your joystick is going to be kind of screwed up. It's going to be to the left more, to the right more, and when you try to use it, your joystick is going to tilt itself and turn itself without you wanting it to do so. So, for example, in Pac-Man, I was trying to use and play with the joystick around, and I tried to see if anything would work well, and I tried to maneuver Pac-Man, and every single time I tried to do something, Pac-Man would smash his face into the floor. Now, I know there are no floors in Pac-Man, because it's Pac-Man, it's 2D, but either way, Pac-Man would not go anywhere, and it kind of sucked. Now, Iron Man is kind of the only game that I can actually get this to align with, because it's the only game that actually seems to work well. Now, games like Pac-Man, where there is no left, up, left, right, up, like multi-directional, besides up, down, left, and right. If they're a game of Pac-Man implies that you're only going up, down, left, and right. In this game, you can kind of have like a whole gyroscope where you can go up, down, left, right, any direction you really want. It goes in a full 360-degree circle. Pac-Man goes four directions. Now, if there are four directions, that means that this, if not applied perfectly, the joystick is going to be leaning in one of those directions. So if you're going to try to maneuver the joystick while it is leaning in one of those directions, which quite frequently it does lean in one of those directions, it's going to be a really bad experience, in my opinion. And my opinion is probably shared with a ton of people that have tried to play games like that with this joystick attached. Now let's try to play Iron Man with this. And let me just get through this little demo thing so that I can get this done faster. And we'll just skip through that, skip through that, skip through that. So as you can tell, we're flying through Times Square right now. Well, now we are. And I can control Iron Man pretty easily. Now, as you can tell, he's leaning down. I'm letting go. He's smashing into buildings and leaning down. Now, that is overcomable, and it is not the worst thing in this game. And Iron Man is just one of those games where you can overcome it because you can tilt it, and it's not tilting it that much. But other games like Pac-Man and 9mm, you're tilting in a direction that you don't want to go in, and it's hard to get over that because you really can't overcome that because it's like you have a third finger pressing against your finger, and that finger is just kind of pressing the character in the game in one direction, and you're trying to get them into the other direction, and it kind of screws everything up because you can't maneuver the person at all. So if this is going up and I'm trying to go down, that means that I have less functionality when I try to go downwards, because part of the joystick is devoted to pushing it up. So it's kind of a strange mix of different stuff that I have to say about this. I like it in the sense that it makes it easier to control the game. I definitely know that, and I'm telling you guys, the game is much easier to control with this. However, you do lack and compromise when you have to control the game. The guy is leaning in a direction that you don't want them to lean in, and that is where it gets annoying, and that is where I don't like it. But otherwise, it's a pretty good joystick. I give this a 7 out of 10, 6 out of 10. It's not that good of a product, in my opinion, because the joysticks have this moving around, and when it moves around, it really screws up the alignment even more. Not only is it the fact that you can only get this to line up perfectly, I'm talking pinpoint accuracy, 100 out of 100 times, you'll get it once. Out of that, it's not that good of an odd that you're going to get this to align perfectly. And if you don't align it perfectly, which odds are you will not, it's probably going to screw up the gameplay and make it less enjoyable than it were without the joystick. So that one time where it does work properly, you're going to get really annoyed because that's only one time. And the rest of the 99 times, it sucks because your character, you can't control them because the joystick is interfering with it. So I personally give this a 7 out of 10, 6 out of 10 because it's not that good. I like it. It's kind of okay. Depends on the game you're using. Iron Man didn't affect it that much, but 9mm and Pac-Man, it totally sucked for those. I have no other word for that besides suck, because it did suck. And so do these suction cups. They both suck. And I hate it. I really hate the suction cups. But otherwise, it's okay, in my opinion. So with that, guys, I'll give you guys the link for this product down in the video description. It does not work for the iPhone, in case you're wondering. And I will tell you guys, do this at your own risk. It might work for your iPad, it might not, depending on what games you're using, depending on how you apply it. It really depends on the person. I was not able to apply it. I had other people try to apply it. We're not able to do it. So I'm just telling you guys, it at your own risk if you want to purchase this. I would do it if I were you, if you're a careful person that has the time and patience to apply this and really spend time doing this so that they get the perfect alignment. But otherwise, guys, rate, comment, and subscribe. Thumbs up the video. I'll have links for you guys down in the video description. And peace. If you like this video, feel free to subscribe. Also, you guys can go share this with your friends, favorite, like, and comment on this video. Also, feel free to check out the previous video, which you can see right here. Annotation is right there, and go ahead and click on it.